الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. اللهم اغفر للشيخ الحانوتي، اللهم اغفر للشيخ الحانوتي، اللهم اغفر للشيخ الحانوتي، اللهم ابدله دارا خيرا من داري، وأرضا خيرا من أرضي، وأهلا خيرا من أهلي، وزوجا خيرا من زوجي. A man who lived his life trying to serve people through many ways. Everybody will talk about this, so I don't have to repeat the same thing, but I have something else to share. Yesterday morning, I dropped my phone in the water. That's an iPhone, so it stopped working. So I was very concerned because I am an intensive care specialist. I take care of small babies and intensive care. So I was so keen to go and find a replacement, and I went to work, and then I left work early, went to the store, and I spent too much time, and I was like willing to pay anything just to get a new phone so that I don't lose contact if they call me from the hospital. And this happened before to me, like several months ago. I changed the phone and I lost contact. So there is something in my mind that I have to keep connected to the source of my work, the source of my income, so that I don't have any issues trying to reach out and could be reached. At the same time, this happened, and we lost Sheikh Al-Hanouti. And one of the very last words he told Dr. Muhammad Ashraf before he passed away, one of the words he said, "I am not afraid from death. I'm not afraid to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." So it just came to my mind how I was very keen to keep the connection to my job, my people, my contacts, my family. And what did Sheikh Al-Hanouti do in his life and ended his life so that he felt that he is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he is ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever this happened. It just like it came to my mind all through the day today, when, like, regardless of who attended Sheikh Al-Hanouti, how many people there, 1,000, 10,000, we know of people that died and only one person prayed on them. And we know Hassan al-Banna was only his father, who was the only man there. And Hassan al-Banna is not in a list from Sheikh Al-Hanouti. So it doesn't matter how many were there, but like both Sheikh Al-Hanouti and Hassan al-Banna and many other good people that led the Muslims across the whole history of Muslims, they were well connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to verify this in ourselves and reflect. Are we every single day, in every single moment, if we meet death right now, we are ready? Inshallah ta'ala, Sheikh Al-Hanouti will be one of them, inshallah. And inshallah ta'ala, all of us need to reflect on this and be the same thing, that we have to be ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at any time. The same way that we are very keen, like me, to have the phone working all the time, and ready to receive the call if there is a sick baby. I have to rush within 30 minutes or less to be in the hospital to save this baby. Are we ready if the message of Allah came that this is your time right now? Are you ready now to meet Allah now? Are you ready? No sins. Like we all do sins. Are we making istighfar all the time to be ready? I don't know what, again, Sheikh Al-Hanouti do. When you look at the scholars and Imam Shafi'i and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal and the others, that when there is a story, I'm not sure about its authenticity, but Ibn Hanbal came in the dream after his death to one of his students, and he was in a good condition. So his students told him, "Oh Imam, what made you acceptable in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" So Imam, he told him that it wasn't of the knowledge we taught or what we did, it's because of few rak'ah that we did in the middle of the night. So Imam Hanouti will stand, Mufti Hanouti will talk, will teach, will give all what you know about him. But he had something else between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that kept him connected all the time. Being in front of people sometimes goes into your heart. So I'm sure that he did not depend on the knowledge and the ilm that he was teaching and giving fatwa based on it. He had some other connections with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, made his heart on all the time, ready to receive the message and ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We got to know behind his back that despite that I am the chairman of the Rajra, and I know that Sheikh Hanouti, when it comes to money, he wouldn't get the highest, or not even the second highest or third highest. He was barely living on what we gave him, and this was what we were all able to give to him. But despite that, he will lead the giving to many families. If he can't find anyone to give them, he will take care of it by himself, and no one knows that. And he will do it for people, and we will hear from others talking about him. He is doing that all the time. Despite that, he was barely living on what finances we were able to support him with. But he wouldn't forget about this. We'll have some action, some deed between him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that no one else knows. Maybe when he stands and gives khutbah, people praise him, and this gets to his heart. Allah a'lam, maybe not. But he didn't depend on that. He depended on some other ta'ah, some other deeds that kept him connected. So when his time came, he was ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept him and accept from him. Wallahu musta'an. Jazakumullahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.